There are several constructs that help us alter the program flow based on some conditions. We'll look at if-then-else statements, case statements, guards, and conditional return types. Let's start with if-then-else. The if-then-else statement in Daml is quite similar to what you may have seen in other languages. Here in the example, we have a function if-odd or even that uses an if statement to print even or odd for a given number. The signature says that it takes one int argument and returns text. If x modulo 2 is 0, then it returns even, or else it returns odd. As usual, you can add more if statements to the block if you have more conditions to test. An important point to note here is that unlike some other languages where you may write an if statement without an else, Daml requires you always provide an else statement to cover both sides of the Boolean condition. Another way of thinking about an if-then-else statement is that it's not just a statement, but also an expression that must return a value. If you have too many if conditions to check, making your if-else block too bulky, then you have an option to use guards to make your code a little more concise and readable. Like if statements, you check for Boolean conditions, but instead of if-else, you separate them using a vertical pipe symbol. This example, find BMI, takes two decimal inputs and returns a text based on the BMI value. BMI stands for body mass index and is computed as weight divided by height squared, where weight and height are in kilograms and meters respectively. If the computed value is less than 18.5, then the function returns the text underweight. If less than 25, then normal, and so on. The last guard otherwise is a catch-all. Now you may notice that this is not a good idea to repeat the formula for every condition, and to address that, we use what is called where binding. Using the sample example as before, you can use a variable BMI in each guard condition, and then bind that variable to the formula in the where block below. This makes your code much more readable and efficient. You can bind as many variables as needed in this where block. Another similar construct is case statement, which works the same as an if statement, but uses pattern matching instead of Boolean conditions to branch. Taking the example of odd or even, the case odd or even function takes an int and returns a text. It computes x modulo 2 and then matches the result with the patterns listed below. If the result matches 0, then the function maps to return value even. If it matches 1, then odd. The underscore in the last pattern is a catch-all, which is taken if none of the patterns listed above match. There is a data type called either, which represents a type with values of two possible data types. It's written as either AB, which means either a value of type A, or a value of type B. This data type has two constructors, left and right. The left constructor constructs a value of type A, and the right constructor constructs the value of type B. Let's look at an example of how this works. We have a function called sumFunction, which takes an int and returns either text or an int. The function definition shows that if the input x is less than 0, then it uses the left constructor and returns a text with value error. This is the type on the left of the two possible types. If x is not less than 0, then the right constructor is used, which returns x plus 2, which is of type int, which is the type on the right of the two possible types in the function signature. Then in the script, when you apply the function as sumFunction negative 2, it uses the left constructor and returns the text error. When you apply the function as sumFunction 2, it uses the right constructor and returns an int as 4. The most common use of the either data type is in error handling, where by convention the left constructor holds the error value and the right container holds the correct or the right value. Let's go over what we've covered. We've learned about three techniques of altering the control flow based on some conditions: if-then-else, guards, and case statements. While if-then-else and guards use Boolean conditions to branch, case statements use pattern matching. We then looked at a special data type called either, which represents a type with two possible data types, one for the left and right constructors to construct the value of these two types.